Hey guys, how's it going? So I've got a little battle here. This is a rematch against MultiWhite97. I battled this guy previously and I kind of owned him a bit with my bravery. So yeah, I'm just gonna, this is a rematch. Now I lead off with this. I'm actually using the same team as what I did before, but with more tweaks. Essentially, I know I said before that this team could do a bit of a few tweaks, so this is basically the end result. So he's got a Dust Noir, I've got Mind Shout, and he takes my Stone Edge really well, surprisingly. You know, he actually told me after the battle, though, he actually has max HP and max defense, and he's really a Trick Room team, which, you know, was cool. I hardly ever face those anymore. Well, I've faced a few people with Trick Room, but not that many in the long run. So I'm thinking, well, Mind Shout's quite useful because it's quite fast, so I'm thinking I'll go out to Tematic, because obviously Will-O-Wisp is coming, and I can just, you know, get my Marvel Scout activated early. So, you know, although I do take damage early as well, but no matter. So he goes for an Earthquake. It's not really going to do that much because I have, like, Marvel Scout activated. In fact, it does, like, nothing, actually. Go for a Toxic here because it's the best way to deal with Dust Noir, and it seems quite familiar, this does, so yeah, that's basically a personal preference thing, don't get too hung up on that. So yeah, I'm taking burn damage, of course. He goes for the Earthquake again. Again, I guess it's the best choice he's got. I thought he might carry Thunder Punch, but I guess he doesn't have it. Go for a Recover here, because I could just Toxic Stall this thing to death. Because one of the problems with Trick Room is it only lasts 5 turns. And in all fairness, it doesn't usually last that. It's not that long, in all fairness, when you consider it in the long run. Sure, you can just set it back up once it's down, but there's no guarantee you'll be able to get it back up, which are limitations. But apart from that, it's actually a great strategy. So I'm just going to go for the Surf here, because there's no point in going for a Recover, I just thought I might as well get some damage off. Because I think the Poison kills him this turn. Yeah, oh no, it doesn't quite kill it though. So I'm just going to, he's twisted the Dimension turn to normal, and I'm just going to go for the Surf here, because I just want to get rid of this thing, because, you know, it was proving a bit of a nuisance. So anyway, I get a useless critical hit there, and could have done that the first time around. Actually, no, it doesn't actually matter. No, critical hits weren't really helpful in this situation at all. Maybe at the start, but you know. Yeah, it would have been useful with Mind Shout. Yeah, it would have been useful to have that with Mind Shout. Brings in how do you pronounce this thing? Kofagrigus, I think it's pronounced. So he sets up Trick Room here, and this Kofagrigus, I'm just going to call it Kofagrigus because I've probably gone about saying that right. Yeah, Kofagrigus. Oh, I forget it. I'll just call it Kofagrigus. So, it's actually a nasty plot set with this thing. It's actually pretty cool. And I'm going to go for a Recover here. And I think I make a few bad plays here. I don't know. I can't remember actually. But I do get my Recover off, so that's helpful. And plus I've got Toxic Recovery, Toxic Support going. Plus I have my, Marvel Scout activated. So he goes for a nasty plot, another nasty plot here, which is pretty nasty because I think this thing has quite a high special attack stat. I will admit, I don't know much about this Pokemon. I'll admit, I probably should research it a bit to know what to expect. So have another Recover here. I was hoping I could have taken at least one because I do have max special defense with this thing. At least I think I do. Anyway, and he gets for a Shadow Ball here. I was hoping, I knew it would do a lot, but I was hoping I'd live it. But I don't think I do live it. Hang on, let me see. Nope, I die. So anyway, yeah. So my Milotic goes down and I'm thinking, what should I do now? I know what I'll do. I'll wait for the stuff to happen and that, and I'm gonna bring in Metagross because I know the poison will definitely kill it the next time, and I'm just gonna go for the bullet punch here to get as much damage off as possible. I'm actually, you know, I actually just pulled Metagross in just because of, you know, just to get some damage off, you know, and he gets another Shadow Ball. I think I die as well to the Shadow Ball, but I can't remember. I don't think I live. Do I live? No, I don't. No, I didn't think I did. But it doesn't really matter because this turn I've got the Toxic that's going to. Oh, she's actually got Life Orb as well. No wonder it's so powerful. So, yeah, he does go down, thankfully. So that's another bullet dodged, sort of. And the Dimension turned to normal, so I'm like, oh, great. So I'm going to bring in Brave Barry now. And he brings in a. What's this thing? Oh yes, he brings in Chris Celia, which is like, I can't believe. Would you believe this thing is all you? I can't believe, I don't see how that's even logical. I don't see how Chris Celia is all you. It should be you at least. You know, I mean, it's okay here because this is an OU match, but why is this thing all you? It should not be an all you. Yeah, in fact, I wouldn't guess what to say. Maybe even Mandibus shouldn't be an all you, but I don't know. So, he goes for an ice beam here, and I think I die. I can't remember, do I? No, I don't. I actually live. And I go for another Brave Bird here with bravery, and it doesn't kill, of course, but it does do quite a lot. Yeah, but actually, it does quite a chunk, actually, surprisingly, for Cresselia. I'm guessing it's not defensive. Maybe it's special defense, special base, but I don't know. So he's gonna, of course, he's gonna go for another ice beam here and finish off my Brave Valley. I guess he got his revenge from the last match because his Brave Valley is the one that sweeps in last turn. So yeah, I guess he got his revenge on that part. So anyway, bring in Dark Manitan now because I'm thinking, I think Ice Beam's the only attack he's got. Oh no, he hasn't. He's got Moonlight. So far, we've seen Trick Room, Moonlight, and Ice Beam. I don't know what the last move is. Not sure at all what it is. So anyway, go for a Flare Blitz here. I know this will do a chunk because I've got like Sheer Force and Life Orb and Stab. I knew it would do a lot. I was hoping it would kill, but it doesn't quite kill it. I'm like, oh, give me a break. Yeah, because I don't take that much recoil though, surprisingly, not compared to how much I actually did anyway. He goes for an Ice Beam, which tells me that's the only attack he has got. I don't know what his last move is. So, you know, I'm just going to go for the Flare Blitz here and finish off this annoying Cresselia. And here's a bit of nice news for you that you may not know. Right, Sheer Force actually removes the effect of Life Orb. That's right, guys, it actually removes the effect of Life Orb. But only if you're using a move that Sheer Force affects. So, like, I'm using Earthquake now. Right, I will take Life Orb Recoil now, because Sheer Force does not affect Earthquake. So he goes for a Psychic here, and that Earthquake did a bit more than I thought it would, but Darmanitan goes down because of the thingamajig. Now, I don't know why, if it had been me, I'd have set up what's her name? Now, here is my new team member for this team, Viridian. Now, let me tell you something. Viridian is epic. Alright, this Pokemon is definitely one of my favourite 5th gens ever. It's like, awesome. It's got an amazing special defense stat. It's pretty good special attack. I've actually got a Life Orb set here. And he brings in Bloodsway, which is cool. So I can't see that anymore. How many times have I said that? How many times have I said this is pretty cool because I don't see that anymore? Yeah, and I actually have Giga Drain because Giga Drain actually goes nicely with Life Orb's downside, so whatever life I lose, I can recover. Well, sort of. So he goes for an Ice Fang here, does a lot of damage, but it does actually survive, which I did not expect. Then again, he doesn't have Guts activated yet, so yeah, in case you guys don't know, in 5th generation, Luxray gained Guts as its hidden ability, so that's pretty cool. Very useful to it, actually. I only wish it learned. Does it learn Sucker Punch? I don't think it does. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. So, Luxray goes down, and I think he's going to test Pokemon now. So, he brings in Wipeyu. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's game, because, well, Wipeyu can't take a Giga Drain. So, yeah, guys, that's the end of the match. So, good game, MultiWhite97. That was actually pretty intense, because I was a bit worried when I saw Trick Room. I thought, uh-oh, I think I may be in trouble here. So, that was actually a really challenging match, you know, so... Anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you in the next episode, and goodbye.